Hello viewers, welcome to Number X. In this video, I am going to share a question through which you can learn another problem solving skill. Please consider subscribing to my channel so that you can learn new problem solving skills each time. The question is as follows. If alpha and beta are the roots of the quadratic equation k plus 1 times x squared minus 20k plus 14 times x plus 91k plus 40 is equal to 0, where alpha is less than beta, and k is a positive real number, then we have to find the intervals in which alpha and beta lie. If you are thinking of solving the problem using discriminant, that is, discriminant is greater than 0, then you will get valid ranges of k, but you may end up with two equations, one involving sum of roots and another product of roots. Finally, you may get stuck at the end. So here, I am going to suggest an easier approach to solve this problem. Let us consider h of x is equal to k plus 1 times x squared minus 20k plus 14 times x plus 91k plus 40. Now, h of x can be written as a linear combination of two quadratic polynomials as kx squared minus 20x plus 91k plus x squared minus 14x plus 40. After factorization of each quadratic, we get k times x minus 13 times x minus 7 plus x minus 10 times x minus 4, which can be further written as f of x plus g of x, where f of x equals k times x minus 13 times x minus 7 and g of x is equal to x minus 10 times x minus 4. Let us analyze the graphs of f of x and g of x by breaking the domain into 5 intervals. First, when x is less than or equal to 4. In this interval, the value of h of x is always positive because f of x and g of x are non-negative. Hence, h of x will not have any root in this interval. Second, when x lies between 4 and 7. In this interval, the value of h of x may be 0 because f of x is positive and g of x is negative. Hence, h of x will have a root in this interval. Third, when x is greater than or equal to 7 but less than or equal to 10. In this interval, the value of h of x is always negative because f of x and g of x are non-positive. Hence, h of x will not have any root in this interval. Fourth, when x lies between 10 and 13. In this interval, the value of h of x may be 0 because f of x is negative and g of x is positive. Hence, h of x will have a root in this interval. And lastly, when x is greater than or equal to 13, in this interval, the value of h of x is always positive because f of x and g of x are non-negative. Hence, h of x will not have any root in this interval. Since alpha is less than beta, hence alpha will lie in open interval 4, 7 and beta will lie in the open interval 10, 13. At this point of time, I am sure that now you can easily solve such problems. Please consider subscribing to my channel if you have not subscribed yet. See you in the next video with a new problem solving skill. Thanks for watching.